Hi, Professor Isardella. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you a priming of centrifugal pump. We are discussing its introductions and various method of priming for a centrifugal pump. So we just starting with introduction of priming. So this is the figure of centrifugal pump. So you already know this component. If you don't know the component of centrifugal pump, then I request to go in the playlist and watch the component of centrifugal pump. For that, link is also provided on the top right screen from the eye symbol, so you can go to the playlist. When pump is first put into the service, okay, so its passageway. Passageway means its suction pipe. This is the suction pipe. This circular component is casing, and this is the delivery pipes are required to fill it with water. Okay, so why it's required to fill it with water? So initially, the pump, we are going to start the pump at that time air is available inside this suction pipe, this casing and this delivery pipe. Okay, so air is not able to create the head because density of the air is lower than the water. So air is not able to create the particular head. So due to that, water suction is not possible from the sump. Means water is not start to come into the suction pipe from the sump level. Okay, that's why we are required to fill the water by manually or different methods that we discussing later on. Okay, so we are filling the waters by using this various method. So here I write that pressure head generated by the air is negligible compared to pressure head generated by the water. Hence, initially water may not be sucked by the pump from a sump. Okay, that's we already discussed. Now, next point is that therefore, to avoid this, before first time start the pump, air must be removed from this passageway. Okay, so air is removed by adding the waters by different methods that we discussing, and these methods of removing the air from the different passageway like the suction pipe, casing and the some part of this delivery pipe, it is known as the priming. So priming is the operations of filling a passageway from the outside source without the liquid to be raised before starting the pump. Okay, so removing the air from this different passageway by filling this water, it is known as the priming. Now we move towards the types of priming. Before that, I request to like the video, subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons, and also press the bell icon to get continuous notification. So types of priming. So first is the manual priming methods. Second one is the priming with vacuum pump. Third one is priming with jet pump. And the last one is the priming with separators. So first we start with the manual priming. So here it is the figure. Okay. So in a manual priming, we are putting the one funnels in the delivery pipes. It's the manually means we are adding the water manually through this delivery pipe. Okay. So what is the first step? So we are required a funnel. And we are adding the water, small water vessels. Okay, and this water is going into these different parts of the pump, that is the suction pipe, casings, and the some part of these delivery pipes. This portion is known as the air vent. Okay, in these methods of priming, water is pure into the pump through the priming funnels. So this is the one funnels through which we are adding the water manually. Okay, means by human being or a man that supplying the waters from these funnels, and water is going in this pump. When the priming is being done, air is escaped through the air vent valve. Okay, so this is the air vent valve. So when we adding these waters, we are required some space from where the air is removed. So we are starting to add the waters. So water is first fill this suction pipe, then fill this casing. Okay, up to this level. Then we switch on the switch of the pump. When all the air is exhausted from the casing, suction pipes and portion of this delivery pipe, the water will flow out through the vent valve. Means from this air vent, water is also coming out. Okay, so that means our priming is completed. And the air vent valve is closed once the priming is completed. Okay, when the water is start to come from this air vent valve, we close this air vent valve. Then after we start the pump and water is start to delivered, or pump is start to deliver the water into this delivery tank. So these are the manual methods. Okay. Now, if you learn something, then like the video. Second method is by using this vacuum pump. Vacuum pump means we are require one another pump to create the priming. Okay. So priming with vacuum pump. This vacuum pump means small reciprocating pump is used. The small size reciprocating pump, that means vacuum pump is used to priming the main centrifugal pump. The suction line of this reciprocating pump, this is the reciprocating pump, it is connected with delivery pipe. So one end is connected with this delivery line. Okay, so you know that this is the delivery pipe. One end of this connected with this delivery pipe, and the another end is connected to this atmosphere. When manually operated reciprocating pump is started, this pump it slips the water from the sump to suction line, casing portion of delivery lines of the centrifuge. This vacuum pump is manual or either it is operated by electric motors. When we start to rotate this reciprocating pump or a vacuum pump, it starts to suck the first air from the suction pipe, then the casings and the delivery pipe. That means it creates the vacuum, and due to this vacuum, water is start to fill into the suction pipe, then after the casings and some part of this delivery pipe. Okay. Now centrifugal pump is started and it will be able to deliver the waters to the desired level. Okay. So this is a simple. We use the one pump and it is connected with these delivery lines. It creates the vacuum inside these different components. Then after the water level is start to rise into the suction pipe, casings and that, then we start the pump and water we start to deliver the water. Now the third method is by using this jet pump, the priming with jet pump. In this method, water available at the high head is allowed to flow through a nozzle. Means water available at the high head means water available in the delivery tank. So delivery tank is connected with this suction pipe. Okay, so one pipe is take the discharge from this overhead tank or a discharge tank. From that we take the one pipe, here we putting this one valve. Okay, and then its opening is provided in the suction pipe. Okay, and in suction pipe there is a nozzle is provided at that end of this pipe. Okay, then what happen? The nozzle is so designed at that at the jet outside the nozzle, the pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure. Means this nozzle is designed on such a way that here the pressure is below the atmospheric levels. Okay. So it is possible to suck the waters from the sump. So here pressure is reduced below atmosphere. So water from the sump, it start to rise inside this suction pipe. The jet pump is generally fixed in a suction pipe of a centrifugal pump near the sump level. Means this nozzle opening is provided near the sump level. Okay, here it is the end of this jet pump. Okay, and the last one is the by priming using the separators. Okay, so here you saw the side view of the centrifugal pump. In earlier older case we are seeing the front view. Okay, but in this case we use the side view. So in this matter, air separator is provided on delivery side of the pump. Means this is our suction side, this is the pump, and this is the delivery side. On the delivery side means exactly at the outlet of this pump we are provide one air separators. Here you seeing this, it is a air separators. Okay, and the bent suction pipe portion is provided at the inlet of the pump. You know this is the inlet of the pump. So at the inlet we provide this bent shaft. Okay, why this bent shaft is provided? Bent shaft is provided due to reason is that some water is already stored in this bent pipe. Okay, so water level already present, some water is already present in this pump due to this bent shaft. So bent suction pipe portions always contain the some liquids. Okay, then after what happen when we start the pump? Okay, suppose this is the level of bent pipe, so water level is stored up to here. Okay, and air is also present in this pump. So when we start the pump, the air plus water is going in this the air separators. Then what happen? The density of the air is higher. Sorry, density of the air is lesser, so it will move into these delivery pipes. And the water is again fall back into this pump. Okay. So this process is continuous. And the one stage is come, at that time the pump is completely removing the air. Okay, so this pump is completely filled with the water. Then after what happened, the water is start to enter into this suction pipe. Due to that, vacuum is completely created. Why vacuum is completely created? Due to air is completely removed by using this air separators. Okay, so this is known as the, its name is separator, means it separate the air and water. So air is removing through delivery pipe, water is again come into pump, and its process is continuous, and one level is reached. When the complete vacuum is created, water is start to suction in this pump, and then after the pumping, the impeller is start to deliver the water through the delivery pipe. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.